Hi again. In the previous video, we calculated a cable size for our example, but we chose a copper conductor cable. Now we need to recalculate the same example, but for an aluminum cable. Okay, a new page, and we need to draw our example again. Okay, we here we have a power source connected to MDP. Okay, and here we have our load. We need a cable stand up with 100 ampere current. Okay, and the length equal to 100 meter. Okay, we need a cable of aluminium conductor, PVC inner insulation by PVC outer insulation, with the same installation condition, which is depth equal to 0.8 meter and ground temperature equals to 230 Celsius degrees, and we have a grouping, or we have a number of cables in the same trench equals to 3 cables. Okay, this is the first step. Second step, calculate your drating factor or correction factor, and drating factor for the same installation shall be the same as copper conductor. Okay, because the installation conditions related to installation, not to the type of conductor. Okay, so the drating factor shall be the same. Okay, we have a drating factor for installation depth, and we have drating factor for ground temperature, and drating factor for grouping factor shall be 78, and the final result equals to 0.80 when this is our drating factor. Okay, in the third step, we need the absolute current rating. Okay, we need to open the table of aluminum conductor. Here we have copper conductor with reduced neutral, and this table for aluminum conductor, PVC by PVC, okay, multi core, and we will use a 4 core copper conductor of the same cross section. Okay, we need a cable to stand up with 100 ampere. So there is the current rating, and this is our installation lead direct in ground, and 100 ampere and above shall start from here. All cables are acceptable, but we need to multiply this column by our drating factor, which equals to 81. Okay, let's start. Okay, 450 square millimeters multiply 100 and 15 by 0.81 shall be 93, and the 470 135 multiplied by shall be 109 ampere, and the 495 165 multiplied by 0.81 equals to 133 ampere. Okay, the first cable 50 is not acceptable because it shall be a critical. Okay, for 180, this cable is acceptable, and this is acceptable. We will start with 70 square centimeters. Okay, which can load 109. Okay, backing to our example. So after calculating the absolute current rating, we found that 4 cores of 70 square millimeters the cable can load up to 109 ampere, which is acceptable with our example here. Okay, for the fourth step is to calculate voltage drop. Voltage drop equals to V table multiplied by current multiplied by length and divided by 1000. Okay, current 100 ampere, length 100 meter divided by 1000, and we need to find out V table for 70 square millimeters cable backing to voltage drop cables but aluminum conductor. Okay, here we have aluminum conductor multi-core. Okay, PVC by PVC insulation, and here is a 70 square millimeters, and this is our rating factor 0.819. Okay, point 819, and as usual, so we have a voltage drop of 8.19 volt. Okay, and the voltage drop as a percentage, voltage drop divided by V source, we are operating at 380, which means 8.19 divided by 380 equals to 8.19, and multiplied by 100 to get 100% equals to 2.1 as 100%, which is acceptable with my country electrical code because it's less than 500%. Okay, so we will use for cable multi-core cable 4 pi 70 square millimeters a cable aluminum PVC by PVC as a comparison with copper cable. We used 40 square millimeters cables. Okay, and why is that? Because the copper conductor can load more current than aluminum for the same cross section because it has a less resistance than aluminum cable. Okay, see you in the next video.